The movie Dune is a recent blockbuster release and is being hailed by some as the next sci-fi or fantasy epic. It is a universe based far in the future with a medieval-like society with houses and royalty. The in-world logic makes this empire dependent on a resource called spice on the planet Arrakis, or informally known as Dune. This resource spice allows faster than light travel and is the backbone of this star-spanning empire. The technology in the universe of Dune is both advanced and seems to be primitive at the same time. Space travel is common with the help of spice, however, projectile weapons are not in use due to the common use of shields. Shields, both personal and large, that are able to stop virtually all types of projectile weapons unless they are traveling at an extremely slow speed, for example like a dart or a slow-moving arrow. In some rare occasions, projectile weapons are used if you are able to disable the enemy's shields. Thus making the only way to kill a person is usually using some type of object moving at a slower speed, for example a sword or a dagger. As well, thinking computers are banned in the Empire. It is not clear exactly how this is enforced everywhere and at all times, but it is part of the in-world universe. It would seem humans have bred themselves to fulfill roles that computers would normally do, making them have superhuman-like abilities. This type of world building makes the justification for a medieval-like world existing in the backdrop of the far future. The movie takes place when the Empire decides to take control of the planet Dune and give it to another house to oversee the control and harvesting of the resource spice. This is what sparks the initial conflict throughout the movie. So with the setup out of the way, does this movie hold up as the next sci-fi or fantasy epic? For me personally, I would say mostly yes, and let me explain why. The movie does have some very epic scenes, great performances, and some impressive fight scenes and visuals. The world is unique and has great depth to it. The visuals are epic and all the cast do a great job. I found myself instantly invested in the politics, culture, and the human experience of the film. However, for me, the film did fall short in a few areas. Firstly, the movie does seem to drag on a bit in the middle and towards the end of the film, making it seem like it is just 10 or 15 minutes too long. For example, there seems to be many scenes of people simply just looking cool while walking towards the camera. And while these scenes are great looking and a good way to show off the costume design, it just gets old after a few times. And some of the scenes throughout the movie do seem to drag on just a little too long. I do think the film could have benefited from having about 15 to 20 minutes cut off to slim up the film a bit. After the main battle, there is still about half an hour of the film left, which results in an escape and lastly a one-on-one battle minutes before the film ends. The main battle and escape are the climax of the film, so once again it just kind of drags on for 20 minutes with an underwhelming one-on-one battle right at the end. Also, the main battle of the film was a bit of a letdown for me. The main battle takes place when a large force attacks the main base where the protagonist is. I did enjoy it overall quite a bit, but you don't really get to see a lot of the battle, and that was my main complaint. When mixing future armies with swords and whatever else medieval-like technology they would come up with to get around the shield technology, I would expect some type of epic Lord of the Rings-like battle, but with the futuristic backdrop. At one point, two armies are charging at each other, and the film cuts away right before they clash, and you don't actually get to see any of the fighting. And this film doesn't really seem to want to focus on the battle that much. I know the book and the film are supposed to be a human-focused story, which is fine, but if you tease big battles and epic sword fights, please show them to me. All I really wanted was just a few minutes of large armies fighting with swords in the future. But what we really got was just kind of a mediocre battle that really didn't take advantage of what could have been shown. I'm not trying to make this review too negative, but I just needed to explain my few issues I did have with this film. However, overall, this film is a great ride. It does accomplish what it sets out to do, and that is to tell a human story. The rest of it is just a backdrop to that. But those are my thoughts. Please let me know yours, and have a wonderful day.